Good morning, girls. Today we shall learn Unit 16, Plant and Animal Hormones. What are hormones? Hormones are chemical substances produced in the body that controls and regulates the activity of certain cells or organs. They are growth promoters as well as growth inhibitors. In plants, the hormones, or otherwise the phytohormones, control or regulate germination, growth, metabolism like photosynthesis, respiration, plant nutrition, tropism, gnastic movements, photoperiodism, seed dormancy, stomata function and transpiration. In animals, the endocrine system acts through chemical messengers called hormones, which are produced by specialized glands. It regulates the process of digestion, metabolism, growth, development and reproduction. There are five major classes of plant hormones. They are auxin, cytokinin, gibberellins, abscisic acid and ethylene. Among all these, plant hormones auxin, cytokinin and gibberellin promote growth, while abscisic acid and ethylene inhibit plant growth. And so, auxin, cytokinin, gibberellins are called growth promoters, whereas abscisic acid and ethylene are called growth inhibitors. Each phytohormone has a particular physiological function. Auxin plays a major role in cell elongation. It controls stem elongation and gravitropism of roots. Second one, cytokinin. It controls cell division and inhibits senescence. Senescence means aging, and initiates flowering, that is, promotes the growth of lateral buds. Third one, gibberellin. It plays a major role in cell elongation and cell division, and thereby it stimulates the elongation of internode. Fourth one, abscisic acid. It's a growth inhibitor which regulates abscission and dormancy. It increases tolerance of plants to various kinds of stress, so it's called stress hormone. During stress, it causes stomatal closure. Finally, ethylene. It promotes senescence, epinasty and fruit ripening. Let's learn auxin in detail. The term auxin was introduced by Cole and Hagen Smith. Auxins are produced at the stem tip and root tip, from where they migrate to the zone of elongation. Charles Darwin observed an unilateral growth and curvature of canary grass. So in coleoptiles of canary grass, botanical name is Phalaris canariensis. And finally, he came to the conclusion that some influence was transmitted from the tip to the basal region. And this influence was later identified as auxin by Fritz Womolt Wendt. Wendt used Avena coleoptiles for a series of experiments. In the first experiment, he removed the tips of Avena coleoptiles. The cut tips did not grow. In the second experiment, he placed the agar blocks on the decapitated tips. Then, even now, the tips did not show any response. But in the next experiment, he placed the detached coleoptile tips on an agar blocks. Then an hour later, he discarded the tips and placed the agar block on the decapitated coleoptile. It grew straight up, indicating some chemical substance had diffused from the cut coleoptile tips into the agar block, which stimulated the growth. Thus, Wendt concluded that the chemical diffusing from the tip of the coleoptile was responsible for growth, and it is auxin, which mean to grow. Auxins are of two types, natural auxin and synthetic auxin. Auxins which are produced by the plants are called natural auxin. Example, IAA, indole 3 acetic acid. Auxins which are artificially synthesized, they have properties like auxin. Example, 2,4-D, that is 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. PAA, phenyl acetic acid. IAN, indole 3 acetonitrile or natural auxin. Indole 3 butyric acid. Indole 3 propionic acid. Alpha naphthalene acetic acid. 2,4,5-T, that is 2,4,5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid, or some of the synthetic auxin. Let's learn the physiological effects of auxin. Auxin promote elongation of stems. Auxin induce root formation. Auxins of the apical buds suppress growth of lateral buds. Auxin helps to produce parthenocarpic fruits. What do you mean by parthenocarpic fruit? Fruits formed without the process of fertilization. So as a result, seedless fruits are produced. Example, watermelon, grapes and lime. Also, auxin prevent the formation of abscission layer. The next phytohormone is cytokinin. The word cytokinin means cell division. Cytokinins promote cell divisions. It was first isolated from herring fish sperm. Later on, it was isolated from Siamese. Cytokinin isolated from Siamese was Siatin. It is also found abundantly in the liquid endosperm of coconut. About the physiological effects of cytokinin, it induces cell division, the presence of auxin. So as a result, cell enlarges. So it causes cell enlargement. This helps in the formation of new organs from the callus in tissue culture, which is termed morphogenesis. So define morphogenesis. Morphogenesis is the formation of new organs from the callus in the tissue culture. Fourth one, cytokinin promote the growth of lateral buds. The application of cytokinin delays the process of aging in plants, which is termed as Richmond-Lange effect. The next phytohormone is ethylene. It's a gaseous plant hormone. It's a growth inhibitor. It is concerned with maturation and ripening of fruits. During fruit ripening, the raw fruit's pigment, what's the color? Green, so chlorophyll pigment, gets decreased and gradually changes to domination of other colored pigments. Other colored pigments like carotenoids and anthocyanin. So red colored is meant for domination of carotenoids. So green color pigment is changed to colored. Chlorophyll gets decreased and other colored pigments like carotenoids and anthocyanin get increased. And slowly flavor and smell, that is aroma production, followed by the conversion of starch to sugar takes place. So during this gradual change, maximum of ethylene is synthesized. The physiological effects of ethylene. Ethylene promotes the ripening of fruits. Ethylene inhibits the elongation of stem and root. Ethylene hastens the senescence of leaves and flowers. There is aging in plant parts. For example, leaf pigment chlorophyll gets degraded. So as a result, what happens when chlorophyll is lost? Yellowing of leaf. So yellowing of leaf and finally to shedding. Similarly, in flowers, it regulates the blooming of flowers, early blooming. In fruit, ripens. So all these are because of ethylene. So ethylene hastens the senescence of leaves and flowers. Fourth one, ethylene stimulates the formation of abscission zone in leaves, flowers and fruits. That is shedding of the older parts and healed shed zone. This leads to premature shedding. And finally, it breaks the dormancy of buds, seeds and storage organs. Thank you girls. See you next class. Have a nice day.